Good morning. Isn't it wonderful to be here? For we meet in the presence of God.
Green, he leadeth me me to what doth make within the bounds of righteousness, within the bounds of righteousness, for his own name's sake.
Letter to the Romans, chapter 8, beginning at verse 12. Therefore, brothers and sisters, we have an obligation, but it is not to the flesh to live according to it. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the misdeeds of the body, you will live. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God. The Spirit you received does not make you slaves, so that you live in fear again. Rather, the Spirit you received brought about your adoption to sonship. And by him we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children. Now, if we are children, then we are heirs, heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ, if indeed we share in his sufferings, in order that we may also share in his glory. I consider that our present sufferings are not worth comparing with the glory that will be revealed in us. For the creation waits in eager expectation for the children of God to be revealed. For the creation was subjected to frustration, not by its own choice, but by the will of the one who subjected it, in hope that the creation itself will be liberated from its bondage to decay and brought into the freedom and glory of the children of God. We know that the whole creation has been groaning as in the pains of childbirth right up to the present time. Not only so, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, groan inwardly as we wait eagerly for our adoption to sonship, the redemption of our bodies. For in this hope we were saved. But hope that is seen is no hope at all. Who hopes for what they already have? But if we hope for what we do not yet have, we wait for it patiently. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This next reading was part of the Gospel a few weeks ago, and again last Thursday. I have to say I was delighted to see it was listed as one of the readings for this service today. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble at heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. May it be given to me to speak to you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. When these few verses were part of the Gospel reading we shared there a few weeks ago, then I mentioned that I think these words are among the most tender and appealing words that Jesus ever uttered. Come to me, all you who are weary and are heavy burden, and I will give you rest. I also shared one of my favourite Joy Webb pieces, Share My Yoke, and now I'm sharing it with other people, and Natasha said how much she enjoyed listening to it. I haven't included it today because I thought it was a bit of an indulgence having it three times in a row, but it is one of my favourites. So don't worry, I'm not playing it today. But the first time I didn't use the second verse, mainly because of time constraints in the services. But these are the words we hear in the third verse, the second verse. When I've lost the things that always seem so sure, it's then I need to hear him say, share my yoke. Over these past few months, we've heard it said many times, the new normal. And there are those I speak to who say, when will we ever get back to normal? I'm not sure that I know the answer to any of those questions. It seems as if all the things we were sure about are no longer there. We're now unsure. In this changing landscape, we are no longer sure about anything. And that can be really, really scary. And yet, when we stop to think about the things that we value most, they're still there. And perhaps we appreciate them even more now. You will have seen some of the people I've met in the little feature that I've been doing, asking anyone who would stop and talk to me. And interestingly, nobody has said no yet. I'm putting that out there, and of course they're going to start now, aren't they? Asking them how they are and what they've learnt about themselves or what they're missing during lockdown. Overwhelmingly, people have missed family, friends, going out to lunch, coming to church, those kind of things. If I asked you, I'm sure that they would be the same things for you too. Maybe the odd round of golf or going to play table tennis or other things like that. I know the services that we've been doing online are appreciated because many of you have told me so. And God has really blessed us as a church as we navigate the terrain. We're together, aren't we? But that's not what we're used to. This is a house of prayer, and it's not the same when we couldn't pray in it. And from my perspective, it isn't the same when you're not here. It doesn't feel right. It doesn't even sound the same when you're not here. Now, when I meet people, I will change the question I ask. If I happen to meet you in the street, you know what's coming. I'll ask you how you are. But I may also ask you, what has lockdown helped you appreciate? Now more than ever. For me, I guess what I've learned, and I appreciate more than ever, is that when I'm tired and nothing's going right for me, it's then I need to hear him say, share my yoke.
Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, and you are mine.
Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, and you are mine.
When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned.
I have called you by name, you are mine.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, and you are mine.
Let us pray together. O Lord our God, giver of life and growth, grow in us a longing for you, that we might deepen our faith. Grow in us a compassion for your world, that we might serve our neighbours. Grow in us a vision for your kingdom, that we might proclaim your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray today for communities here and elsewhere in the world damaged and traumatized by the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic. Our prayers begin with our concern for children and communities in Tamil Nadu, India, where infections persist, and the lives of Father Anthony and our friends in Kalupati and Parialakam continue to be made enormously difficult. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the people of Catalonia in Spain, where the experience of infections and deaths have continued to cause distress and hardship in villages, towns, and in Barcelona. We pray for the people of Melbourne, where increased infections have brought renewed restrictions and distress in the city and in the state of Victoria. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for communities here in the United Kingdom and the impact the virus is still having on the lives of many people. We pray for those who have survived treatment in intensive care and who are still affected by the memories of their time there. We pray for doctors and nurses who for many weeks have been treating patients in great distress and have seen many die in their care. We pray for families who are bereaved, who have faced the loss of a loved one, who are unable to share their suffering, unable to say goodbye as they would like to, and still lost in grief, they may be unable to share as they would wish. Our prayers go out to residents and carers in care homes across our country, where their experience of infection is still raw, and where they may still feel isolated and vulnerable. For all these people and families, Lord, bring your love and your support at this time. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the restoration of Christian congregations and churches across the Diocese of St. Edmundsbury and Ipswich at this time. And we give thanks for the restoration of our worship in St. Andrew's Church, Rushmere, this Sunday. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray that our community here in Rushmere, that life for all of us in a changed world is full of optimism and hope. We pray that our Christian community here is resilient and resourceful in adapting to the challenges ahead. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those who are unwell at this time, especially for those known to us. Today we pray for Janet, Ellen, Janet, Evelyn and Ted, Roger and Mary, Doreen, Janice, Matthew, Tom, Betty, and Nafat. And we pray for those members of our community who have died recently. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And for this morning, a prayer to take home with us. O living God, giver of light and joy, enter our lives and make us thine. Be thou our light, that we may see clearly all that is good and all that is wise. May our lives be bright with thy glory. May our words be kind with thy kindness. May our deeds be good with thy holiness. May our minds be wise with thy wisdom. May our hearts be filled with thy peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Thank you, Paul, for those prayers. Thank you. This has been a difficult time for so many. It still is. But now we look to change focus to Thanksgiving. There have been some amazing stories, haven't there, come out of lockdown. For example, Sir Tom getting his knighthood this week. Wasn't that an amazing story? Things, great is thy faithfulness.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. sun, moon, and stars in their courses above. Join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy. Faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord. Sin and a peace that endureth, thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide, strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow, blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
So we remain seated as we affirm our trust in the faithfulness of God, using these words from Psalm 46 on page 5. The Lord is with us. He is our stronghold. God will help us at the break of day.
The Lord is with us. He is our stronghold.
God will help us at the break of day. God is our refuge and strength, ready to help whenever we are in trouble.
God will help us at the break of day.
We will not fear, even if the earth shakes and the mountains topple into the sea.
God will help us at the break of day.
Come now and look at the works of the Lord, the awesome things he has done on earth.
God will help us at the break of day.
Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth.
God will help us at the break of day.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
The Lord is with us. He is our stronghold. God will help us at the break of day.
The Old Testament reading is taken from Genesis chapter 28, commencing at verse 10. Jacob left Beersheba and went toward Haran. He came to a certain place and stayed there for the night, because the sun had set. Taking one of the stones off the place, he put it under his head and lay down in that place. And he dreamed that there was a ladder, and set upon the earth, the top of which reaching to heaven. And the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. And the Lord stood beside him and said, I am the Lord, the God of Abraham, your father, and the God of Isaac, the land on which you lie. I will give it to you and to your offspring, and your offspring shall be like the dust of the earth, and you shall spread abroad to the west, and to the east, and to the north, and to the south. And all the families of the earth shall be blessed in you and in your offspring. Know that I am with you, and will keep you wherever you go, and will bring you back to this land. For I will not leave you until I have done what I have done, what I have promised you. Then Jacob woke from his sleep and said, surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it. And he was afraid and said, how awesome is this place? This is none other than the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven. So Jacob rose early in the morning, and he took the stone that he had put under his head and set it up for a pillar and poured oil on the top of it. He called that place Bethel, but the name of the city was Luz at that time. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
So you've had a few minutes to think about it. What would you give thanks for today? Now, there was a discussion early on that we weren't sure how to say Luz, whether it was Luz, what it was called. So we thought we would replace that name with, what was it?
Felixstowe.
And I'm guessing there are people that would like to give thanks for Felixstowe. It's very close to us, isn't it? And it's got a lovely walkway. We've certainly enjoyed walking along there over this time. So is there anybody else who would like to just offer a name, a word, something that they would like to give thanks for?
Thanks for being together here now.
Thanks for being back together here now.
For friendship.
Yeah.
For the internet.
That lovely hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness. I think thanks for God's faithfulness. And we have needed, He has provided, I think, all we have needed.
Yes, I think you're right. Yes, I know you're right.
Sunshine and rain.
The sunshine and the rain.
Yes, and supportive friends.
Yes. Yes. We had that love at the beginning of lockdown. We had that lovely sunshine, and wasn't it welcome? And then, of course, we wanted the rain because everybody had tidied their gardens up, and now we needed, and we've got the rain. We could do with a bit of sunshine now because people want to go on holiday. So, can we order that next? Anybody? Yes.
I'd like to give thanks to you for all your hard work and your online services.
That isn't what this was about, Kevin. But thank you. If you see how much is on the cutting floor, the cutting room floor, or whatever you call it, virtual anyway, and the amount of times I've told Anthony off just all the way through, so it had to happen again.
He's still doing it.
He's still doing it.
I'm in the clicker.
Thanks, Randy.
Oh, bless you all. Thank you all.
Thank you.
To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul.
O my God, in you I trust.
You are the God of my salvation.
To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul.
In you I hope all the day long.
O God, in you I trust.
Remember, Lord, your compassion and love, for they are from everlasting.
To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. O my God, in you I trust.
How generous is your goodness, O God.
How great is your salvation. How faithful is your love.
Help us to trust you in trial and praise you in deliverance. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord God Almighty is our Father.
He loves us and tenderly cares for us.
The Lord Jesus Christ is our Saviour.
He has redeemed us and will defend us to the end.
The Lord, the Holy Spirit, is among us.
He will lead us in God's holy way, to God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Be praise and glory today and forever.
Please stand for a blessing. Christ, whose glory is in the heavens, fill this house and illuminate your hearts. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with you, those you love, and those who love you, wherever they may be, today and until Jesus comes or calls. Amen.